say your last name.
Abdul Rahman.
Rahman. We were debating.
Jason says, so I thought he was good.
Yeah. There we go.
Back to high school. Mm-hmm. You didn't sign till late. You weren't heavily recruited. That's kind of hard to figure when we watch you out here. How did that happen? How did your recruitment pick up at the end?
I would say coming in early in high school, I kind of didn't play football in the beginning. And then towards the my sophomore to junior year, I really started kind of like going to camps a little bit. And then after that, I started picking up a little small, D1 offers, Toledo and Mercer and stuff like that. And then one of my receiver coaches knew the coach that coached here, Coach Hankin, and they got in contact, and he came and got me like right before signing day. I was like, hey, just come sign. Just come look at the school, see if you like it. And if you do, we can go from there. When I came up here, I felt a great home, and that's what I came.
What do you mean you didn't play football? Did you play other sports? Did you play when a kid and quit, or what do you mean by that?
So I played Little League, so around 6 and 7. And then I took a long time off, didn't play in middle school, and I missed my first year of high school. So I ran track, and I swam, and then I played a little basketball every now and then. But I finally got on back on the field, tenth grade year.
Were you a really good swimmer? I remember Kyle Shermer was a state champion swimmer.
Oh yeah, I was pretty good. I did the butterfly, the freestyle, and then I was in all the relay events. So I was pretty good, pretty fast.
Do you the catch against Tennessee, mm-hmm. pretty memorable. Have you looked back at that play? Have you YouTubed it? How often have you looked at that since it happened?
After it happened, we have this play mentality where, you make a play, okay, you move on to the next one, you celebrate in that moment, and then you still got some more game to play. So after the game, I knew I scored, but I really wasn't too big on it. But, family members, like my mom, she always kept bringing it up, like, oh my God, you scored. So I was like, okay, that's my job. That's what they recruited me here for. And, I don't look at it as, okay, that's going to be my only play, so let me just remember it forever. It's kind of okay to build off of that.
You had another big catch in the bowl game. Mm-hmm. So we saw you do good things in practice, but then to have two big catches like that at the end of the year, how did that affect your offseason and your confidence?
It really made me strive even harder. Just coming in as a freshman, knowing that I really got to like fight for a spot. And so after that, I made sure that I didn't go back from those two games. I kind of just kept pushing forward, and just trying to be best as guys in front of me, beside me, and behind me.
What's it like playing with Coach Moorhead, and what do you take lessons from him being your position coach?
Him being my first coach here in high school, college, I really feel like he's a great tool to the team, and he really has a lot of knowledge because he played in the league, and he coaches a lot of guys that's still in the league, Pro Bowlers, Super Bowl winners. So he knows the game in and out, and he just trickles down what the information he has to us.
So having been a swimmer before and you ran track and all that, do you kind of consider yourself a pretty complete athlete?
I wouldn't say a complete athlete. I would just say I'm more, versatile when it comes to different sports, and each sport kind of falls into one. You can use different skills that you lose and use in different sports, and they all come together. So they really helped me and put me in an advantage.
What did you do in track? You a sprinter?
I actually threw discus, shot put. I was a triple jumper. I ran the 400, and I ran the 4x4.
What kind of triple jump
did you have? I went to state for triple jump all 4 years. My last triple jump, I am not sure what I had.
But was that your best event, triple jump?
I wouldn't say. I would say shot put was. That was my go-to. And then the 4x4, just a team event.
What do you need to do to get on the field more? Competition for starting spots is intense. There are good players. What are the things that you need to work on to make sure you're out there as much as you can be?
I definitely need to be more inside the playbook, learn more of the plays, learning from some of my guys. Don't take their wisdom as criticism and trying to push me down. Just take what they have to say to me and build off of that. And also just, grind every day when we out here.
Appreciate you, big man. All right.